Last time on Tepster's Tips, we explored human migration out of Africa and how the world was populated. You can find that video at this site. Today we'll be exploring the eastward migration of humans into the Americas and the archaeological and DNA evidence that supports this migration theory. Recently, new methods, data, and ideas have brought us clear understanding of the first humans that crossed into the Americas, with genetic research radically transforming how we perceive human dispersal around the world. The oldest known human occupation within the Arctic Circle is located near Beringia. The archaeology site is known as the Siberia Yana site. It is located near the lower Yana River in northeastern Siberia, Russia, in the far west of Beringia. The site was first discovered in 2001 after erosion exposed animal bones and artifacts and has been dated to a human settlement about 32,000 years ago. This site provides the oldest evidence for human settlements north of the Arctic Circle before the last glacial maximum, 18,000 to 26,000 years ago. In 2019, human teeth dated around 32,000 years ago were found at this site. DNA extracted from these teeth had the paternal haplogroup of P1, which is the precursor to the paternal Q haplogroup that is prevalent in 90% of indigenous people in Central and South America. This DNA established evidence that human settlements in the Yana River region were the ancestors of the first humans in the Americas. How did early humans migrate to America? As glaciers began to melt and sea levels rose after the last glacial maximum, humans had a relatively short window of several thousand years to reach the Americas by crossing the Bering Strait land bridge. Land bridge dates are still being debated. However, some scientists believe it existed from about 30,000 to 16,000 years ago. Models have suggested this land bridge could have lasted as long as 15,000 years or as short as 8,000 years, allowing migrating groups of humans to enter Beringia and cross into North America. The migrating humans followed the grazing herds on the swampy Beringia plains between Asia and America. At times, the land bridge was up to 600 miles wide. Tundra-like conditions would have existed in this area, such as grasslands and shrubs that allowed large animals such as the woolly mammoth and bison to thrive. During the span of about 8,000 to 15,000 years ago, the Bering Strait land bridge was exposed and allowed the free exchange of animals and humans between the Americas and Eurasia. Many species of mammals, including horses, camels, caribou, and black bears, migrated out of North America, while bison, mammoth, moose, elk, and humans migrated into North America. It is interesting to note that there was once camels in America before they went extinct 13,000 years ago. DNA extracted from the bones of a North America camel found in the Yukon in northwest Canada are close relatives of the current Old World camels and not of the llamas of South America. The Bering Strait land bridge was repeatedly exposed and flooded over the past 3 million years, allowing grazing animals many opportunities to cross back and forth from the Americas before early humans came out of Africa. There are three theories on how early humans first reached the Americas. The first theory is what we learned in grade school. First humans crossed the Bering Strait from Asia by a now extinct land bridge. Let's explore this in more detail. The prevailing consensus among archaeologists and geneticists is that the initial human migration to Americas involved a journey by foot across a temporary land bridge known as Beringia, linking eastern Siberia to Alaska. Once they arrived at Alaska, they stayed there until an ice-free corridor opened up and allowed them to advance southward. Recent discoveries at Ice Age archaeological sites, along with a limited number of fully sequenced genomes from human remains, have provided a rough timeline. The distant ancestors of America's first inhabitants departed from Siberia approximately 21,000 to 25,000 years ago. This conclusion is based on genetic comparison between Paleo-Americans and Paleo-Siberians, pinpointing the moment when these two human populations diverged. According to paleoclimatologists, a period known as the last glacial maximum, occurring from 20,000 to 26,000 years ago, saw extensive ice sheets covering most of the northern latitudes. During this time, sea levels dropped significantly due to the accumulation of seawater in ice, revealing a dry land corridor connecting Asia and North America. One of the oldest sites found in North America is at Cooper's Ferry in Idaho that dates back 16,000 years ago. Stone tools and other artifacts were unearthed at the site, and radiocarbon dating the layer found consistently between 14,000 and 16,000 year old. Another find in Florence, Texas, has evidence of human occupation in a soil layer dated 16,000 years ago, with decorated stones and bones engraved with geometric patterns. In 2007, at Paisley Caves in Oregon, the oldest DNA discovered in Americas was found in human coprolite dating about 14.4 thousand years ago. In South America, there is compelling evidence of human habitation dating back 14.8 thousand years ago at Monte Verde, Chile, with radiocarbon dating of bones and charcoal. There is even an older controversial layer at the site that may go back 18.5 thousand years ago. All these sites in the Americas are dated before the famous Clovis, New Mexico site found in 1933 that dated back 12,000 years ago. Geological evidence indicate that the land route from the Bering Strait land bridge through North America was obstructed by thick glaciers until these ice formations began to recede around 15,000 to 14,000 years ago. This brings us to the second theory that involves the first humans arriving in the Americas by boats. The western coastlines of North America were free of ice thousands of years before the interior regions. The first humans might have crossed the Bering land bridge on foot, then employed simple boats to navigate around the glaciers, traveling down the west coast of North and South America. DNA evidence lends support to the coastal boat theory, as the ancient genomes that have been sequenced exhibit the hallmarks of rapid movement, with different lineages diverging swiftly in Americas. People were moving fast, and it's easier to achieve such speed using boats instead of by foot. The third theory involves a trans-Pacific migration sailing across the vast Pacific Ocean in boats. There is no archaeological evidence supporting a trans-Pacific migration. However, there is a faint ancient genetic DNA signal that some native people in the Amazon rainforest of South America share with native Australians and nearby islands. The theory is that a trans-Pacific ocean voyage of 10,000 miles brought a group of people from Australia or islands around it to South America before the Bering Strait land bridge was open. In each of these theories, the migration of the first Americans from Canada to South America happened at a relative fast pace, with human settlements at Monte Verde, Chile, at the tip of South America, as early as 14,000 to 18,000 years ago. Explore more of the migration of humans around the world by subscribing to this channel. The next video will explore human migration into Europe and archaeological sites.